Hey guys, it's Marcus, MPentech, and today I'm going to be looking at the Razer ProClick Wireless Mouse. This is from their new productivity line aimed at professionals, and it retails for around £99 or $99. So it's definitely up there with the other high-end productivity mice, such as the Logitech MX Master. First off, let's quickly look at the specs. It comes with a 5G advanced optical sensor rated at 16,000 DPI. It supports Bluetooth, specifically Bluetooth Low Energy, and it also has 2.4 GHz wireless and wired mode. It has 8 independently programmable buttons. You can connect it with up to 4 different devices. It weighs 106 grams. The battery is expected to last up to 400 hours on Bluetooth and 200 hours on 2.4 GHz wireless. And finally, despite it being a Razer product, there is no RGB lighting. In the box, you simply get a mouse, a carry bag, a micro USB cable, and the instruction manual. Now, upon first inspection, it's a very good looking mouse. I'd probably even go as far as to say it's probably one of the best mouses I've ever seen. It suits my white desk setup quite nicely, and it leaves me wanting to get a keyboard also white just to match it. Overall, the mouse looks great, so almost 4 marks to Razer on this one. The only thing I would comment on is this Razer text on the top. So to me, it kind of just looks a bit wonky. Like, I don't know if it's because of the curvature of the mouse, but it just doesn't seem to line up properly with the rest of the lines on the mouse. I don't know, it's hard to put my finger on, but it's really annoying when I look at it, so I try not to. Other than that, it's great. It looks great on your desk. It looks great in your office. It's a nice looking mouse. Using this mouse, and it's extremely smooth. It feels really nice to use, even without a mouse pad. And, you know, I would probably expect that coming from Razer, who specialize in making gaming mice traditionally. The sensitivity on this mouse is adjustable. It comes with 5 presets and you can flick between those using the sensor button on the top. I find myself using preset 2 out of 5, as anything higher than that is just way too sensitive. As I said before, the mouse has a DPI level of 16,000, which in my opinion is probably a bit overkill for a professional grade mouse. I'd probably expect that more on a gaming mouse than a productivity one. It's an interesting addition on Razer's part, and I'm not complaining, but I do feel like they could have maybe focused more on the productivity side of features than adding this crazy high DPI that we're probably never going to need for professional work purposes. I also think the default presets for the sensitivity could have been lowered a bit. I find myself using 2 out of 5, but I really want to go higher, but I feel that 3 is way too much, so it would have been a bit better to have some more granularity there. Now, you can configure the sensitivity profiles on Razer's software. However, this software is only available in Windows and not on Mac or Linux, which is a huge omission here, especially since this product is aimed at the productivity users. It's an 8-button mouse, so nothing too crazy or special here. The scroll wheel is quite large, which is nice. It also clicks left and right, and by default, that's programmed to do page up and page down. Personally, I never find myself using this. I much prefer the mag speed scrolling on the Logitech MX Master mice, and for those of you who don't know what that is, I'll quickly demonstrate. So you can scroll like normal, but when you want to scroll a lot, you kind of just scroll harder and let go, and the scroll wheel just starts free rolling until you manually stop it. I use this all the time, and it's one of the features I missed most when I was testing out the Razer ProClick. To me, it's a much more natural movement. You scroll the page down a bit and it moves a bit. You scroll it down really hard and it moves down really far. Whereas with this, you know, you click it left or right and it, you know, does page up or down. And to me, that is just really unnatural. And by the time I've actually thought about wanting to do it, I may as well have just scrolled, you know, the old fashioned way. But again, you can reprogram this behavior using the Synapse software in Windows, so you might find some other use for it. On the side of the mouse, you have the back and forward buttons. Again, nothing special here. Most mice have this now. I am surprised they didn't add a side-scrolling wheel on the side here. I mean, this is another big omission for me again. I use this a lot on my Logitech mouse, especially when I'm side-scrolling through code or side-scrolling through DaVinci Resolve timelines. It's just a really useful feature to have. For wireless, the mouse has the ability to use Bluetooth or 2.4 GHz wireless. On Bluetooth mode, it's able to connect to 4 different devices at a time, and the 2.4 GHz works via a dongle, which is located underneath the mouse. The The ProClick sports a micro USB port for charging and also using in wired mode. For those of you who watched my Logitech G915 TKL review, you guys already know how I feel about this. It's 2020, and I know it may cost more, but when you're chasing that £99 or $99 price tag, you need to include this, especially when the competition is already doing so. Finally, the battery. Now this is where I can say Razer has done exceptionally well. I've been using this mouse for 3 weeks, fully testing it every day, and I'm still yet to charge it. Now Razer do claim that this can reach up to 400 hours on Bluetooth, and it is using Bluetooth Low Energy, so that would probably explain it. Full marks here. So in conclusion, it's a weird mouse. I kind of feel that this mouse can't decide what it wants to be good at. Razer are aiming this mouse at productivity users, but they haven't really given it any features to make it stand out in that productivity space. But then there's a few features like the 16,000 DPI and 2.4 GHz wireless, which are staple on a lot of gaming mice. I've tried this mouse at gaming and it's a lot better than using my Logitech MX Master. It's a lot smoother and you can really tell that Razer unsurprisingly know how to make a good gaming mouse. But what it boils down to is where Razer have placed this in the high-end productivity professional user space, which is exactly how I've been reviewing it. In this space, this mouse just really doesn't cut it for me. People who want to do a lot of work and also a lot of gaming might appreciate this, but I'm kind of left thinking, you know, if you were just to get another dedicated gaming mouse, you'd get more features, you'd get like more programmable buttons, you'd get charging docks, you'd get RGB, and I'm kind of thinking, why don't you just get one of those mice instead? It would still be pretty good for productivity and you'd still have all the features you'd have here for the same price. But that's not to say it's a bad mouse. It's really not. I just kind of feel that Razer have slightly misplaced where they're aiming this at. So let's say Razer release this mouse exactly as it is now. Maybe drop the super high DPI. You probably don't need 16,000 for productivity, maybe 10,000. Maybe drop the 2.4 GHz wireless, and let's say they put the price to $60 or £60, around that ballpark. Then I could definitely recommend it. But for now, with the price that this mouse is asking for, it competes directly with the Logitech MX Master 3, which is a way better mouse for productivity. And I haven't even used that yet. I'm just going on my experience of the MX Master 1, and I'm going to be going back to that mouse after I finish this review. If you guys would like me to review the MX Master 3, then let me know in the comments. So that's it guys. If you like this video, hit the like button, hit subscribe, and let me know in the comments what mouse you're currently using. I'll see you guys on the next one.